Hello, I'm Larry Warren. Thank you for joining us on the Believer's Voice of Victory broadcast. The Bible says, with God, all things are possible to him that believe. God's always eager to move on your behalf, but he needs your faith to create the atmosphere for him to work in your situation. Today, Kenneth Copeland will show you how to stay in a place of faith and not give in to fear from the negative circumstances around you. Learn from Jairus' example to fear not and believe only, and boldly receive by faith all God has promised you.
Now Jesus has crossed the lake. He's gotten out of the boat. Jairus has fallen at his feet and said, "Come lay your hands on my daughter, she shall live." Now, he never said anything else. He made his statement of faith, and Jesus totally agreed with him because he just started towards his house with him. He just started down the road with him to Jairus' house. All these people out there are following along, but Jesus, he's not even talking to these people. He's not even saying anything. He has one thing on his mind. He's going to Jairus' house. He's going to go do what this faith man said. Faith has spoken. Faith is connected to him. And when faith speaks, he moves. And so he's headed down there. But suddenly, faith stopped him in the road. Now get hold of the picture here. Look at it as energetically as you can, just like this thing is alive right here in front of you. Because of our lack of knowledge, we've had the idea that this woman was trying to get a hold of Jesus' robe or his coattail or something. It was the shawl around him. She was after the tassels or the fringe on that shawl because she's a Jew. And that represented the anointing to her. And she had heard of Jesus. And she had heard that he's anointed. She had heard he's been called to heal the brokenhearted, preach deliverance to the captive. She'd heard these things. So she came in the press behind to get the hem of his shawl. Now, he's walking here. She touched the shawl. Jairus is here with him. The scripture says he turned to see her who had done this thing. So now Jairus is here. She's here. She told all. She told how long she'd been sick. She told how many physicians had operated on her, and she told that nothing bettered but grew worse. She told that now she is completely impoverished because this disease and sickness, plus all that she'd been through because of it, had stolen all that she had from her, and now she has nothing, including her health. She told all that. That's the reason they knew to write it down in the book. She testified to it. Now, Jairus is standing here listening to all that she said. Jesus said, "Woman, your faith made you whole." Now, remember, we know that it is the anointing that removes burdens and destroys yoke. The anointing went forth out of him, knowing in himself that power, dunamis, anointing, had gone out from him. He turned and said, "Who touched me?" Somebody touched him with a touch of faith. Now, why did he not say, "Daughter, my anointing made you whole"? It did, didn't it? He said, "Daughter, your faith made you whole." Now, there were a lot of people touching him out there, and he just as anointed when they touched him as he was when she touched him. But she touched him with her faith. She came in the press behind, for she said, "If I but touch that shawl, I will be made whole. She didn't say I'll get healed or well. She said, I will be made whole. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Now, Jesus taught a lesson here that Jairus heard. He said, daughter, your faith made you whole. Nothing missing, nothing broken. That means delivered from the blood issue, repaired from the physician problem, and the angels of love himself are now out there gathering and working to bring back all that she had stolen from her through this sickness and disease. To be whole, he had to replace her finances. So Jairus is hearing all this, and Jairus is leader of the synagogue. He understands what Jesus is saying to him. He is anointed. This man is anointed to hear. He understands the word. He knows where Jesus is coming from. He also heard Jesus preach out of the 61st chapter of Isaiah. He knows this. He's hearing all this. Faith is coming. He hasn't said a word, man. Now, he could have been standing there thinking, come on, don't you know she's sick? You ain't got time to mess with her. She's illegal out here to start with. That issue of blood, come on. Had he been thinking like that, he wouldn't have heard a word Jesus said. He wouldn't have heard her testimony. Why? Fear would have contaminated his ear to hear. But he didn't do that. He obviously heard every word. And he understands. He's a man of the book. He's the leader of the synagogue. This is building in him. Now Jesus is looking at this woman. Jairus, now, is right there. This man walks up. Stand here, George, please. Jairus is here. He's right in the middle of this whole thing. This man is in the ministry. This man has a kinship here with Jesus. This is a man of scriptural authority. And Jesus is ministering to this man. This man is at his side. Obviously he has faith because of what he said. Now, come, Stan. This man walks up. Look how close he is here. The woman is right here. Jesus is ministering. This man walks up and says to him, no, you face me. And you walk up to him and you tell him from there, your little daughter
is dead.
Now you look at him. Don't bother the master any further.
Don't bother.
Now the word said, Jesus, hearing what he said, and the Greek text, bear me out in this, Rick, the Greek text said he ignored him. Ignoring, hearing and ignoring. I believe it's amplified, it says it like that. Hearing and ignoring what he said to Jairus, he don't pay attention to this man. Jairus is obviously turned back over here to look at him, and Jesus, ignoring what he said, said, fear not. Now he got his attention. He didn't say, dear Jairus, little buddy, hey, don't pay no attention to him. He didn't even bother with all that. He's looking at him now. Fear not, believe only, and she shall live and be made whole.
Amen. Amen.
Now, you know what happened to him. He's gone. Thanks, George. Now, you know what? Listen to what Jesus said to the man. Fear not. He did not say, Now, Jairus, don't be afraid, man. Let me lay my hands on you and cast that fear out of you. No. He laid the whole thing on him. Fear not. Now, why did that mark Jairus as strongly as it did? Of course Jesus was standing there. Of course he has faith that this is Yeshua Mashiach. He believes this, or he wouldn't be standing there. Of course he believed that. But now, folks, this is still a matter of flesh and blood. A lot of pressure going on here. Why was it so strong in his mind and in his thinking? Remember now, this is a man of the book. I believe with all my heart. He's thinking about Joshua and Caleb. Faith men that did the impossible. And he's running through his heart and through his mind. When Jesus said, "Fear not," he hears Hashem say to Joshua, "Have I not commanded you to be strong? Have I not commanded you, be not afraid?" But every time Hashem, God, love, the Word, said that to anybody, he said it over 110 times. Every time he said it, he never let it fall by itself. He never said, "Fear not." He said, "Fear not, because I am here." Fear not, because I will help you. Fear not, because I am your God, your banner, your glory. I am your righteousness. Fear not, I am your champion. Fear not, I will help you. Fear not, I will never leave you. Fear not, I will not forsake you. Fear not, I will hold your hand. Be not dismayed, I am here. This man knows all this. I mean, this, you know, this ain't Buddy Ruff from down the road. This is a man of the book, man. He knows all these things. He heard all those old prophets. I mean, when Jesus said, "Fear not," I want you to know the Holy Ghost flashed every "fear not" he'd ever heard out of all those books. And he, I mean, "Fear not, fear not, fear not, for I am with you." And he obeyed. Now read into that. Let's look here what Jesus said. And then let's read something into this, what he said. In the 50th verse, Jesus heard it. He answered, saying, "Fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole."
Yes.
It has not been 30 seconds. 30 seconds has not, however long it takes to say that. "Trouble the master no longer, for your daughter's already dead. Fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole." That's got to be about 30 seconds. Since he heard Jesus say to the woman, "Your faith made you whole." Now, he said something to her very pointedly, very exactly, and Jairus heard it. He said, "Daughter, that went over your head like a..." He said, "Daughter, what daughter? The daughter of Abraham. Ought not this woman be loosed from this infirmity, seeing she's a daughter of Abraham?" She knew exactly who she was, and so did Jairus. And Jairus knows he's got the same standing she does. He said, "Daughter, your faith made you whole. Go in..." Now, in the English Bible, how do some of them English translators, I want to talk to some of these guys when I get to heaven. If they're there, some of them. Well, I'm sure they are, forgive me. I've come across some of these things, though, that makes me wonder. Well, I know, you know, they translated this with a with a gun at the back of their head. King James wasn't an easy guy to get along with, you understand? And he didn't say, "Daughter, thy faith has made thee whole, go in peace, and be well of that plague. He used the same word every time. He said, daughter, now remember, she's a Jew, he's a Jew, Jairus is a Jew. We're talking shalom here. Peace, nothing missing, nothing broken. He said, daughter, your faith has made you whole. Nothing you said to me missing and nothing broken. Now you go in wholeness, completeness, and you be whole of that plague. In other words, don't let your faith quit here. You stay in faith, girl. Keep it from now on. Jairus is here and all this. And he tells him, she shall be made whole. Fear not. Go back here and read that with me again. Fear not, believe only, and she shall be made whole. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Now, listen to this. Flip it over and look at it from the dark side. Jairus, if you try to believe and have fear at the same time, if you're going to waver between the two, even if I go home with you, there's not anything I'm going to be able to do about that girl. And even if I just... if I just used my faith and did that, I mean, she wouldn't live long. She wouldn't go and be whole of that, because the fear that's contaminating your faith that got her into this will get her into it again. The same unbelief that put her to bed will put her to bed again. I had someone come to me and ask me while we were on the road. We were in Bluefield, West Virginia, and I was in the hotel there, and getting ready for the evening service, and knock on the door, and they came in, and Brother Copeland, I just need somebody to talk to. It's one of the staff. I said, well, sure. I'm standing thinking, what do they come to me for? I'm the rookie here.
I just need somebody to talk to.
I said, what in the world's happened? I thought maybe, you know, somebody died, run off, or something. And they said,
God has taken his hand off of Brother Roberts.
I said, he did?
Yeah.
I said, how do you know?
Well, we were going back and visiting people that had gotten healed in one of the crusades, and we found out that they got sick again. God has taken his hand off of Brother Roberts.
I said, now, wait a minute. You mean to tell me that his anointing is going to have to keep them well? Well, now, I hadn't been around long, but I've been around longer than that.
Well, I just don't understand it.
I said, Lord, what is this? And I heard it just as plain. I mean, the Lord just said, well, the same unbelief that got them sick again. Amen. They quit believing what he preached. They quit believing what they believed when he laid hands on them. Some kind of a symptom, or somebody said something to them. Some kind of fear came down the road, and they invited it in, contaminated their faith. God didn't have anything to do with it. Certainly, Brother Robert's not going back checking on them. How in the world would you go back and check on 2 or 3 million people?
Well, praise God.
He didn't heal them. And besides that, I don't have time to talk about that anymore. If you try to have faith and fear at the same time, Mr. Jairus, I'm not going to be able to do anything about this. Now, Jesus goes right straight to this man's house, and Jairus gets his third opportunity. to really get shook up. And this one falls right in line with some of the things we heard today. And I'll tell you, it is as strong in its ability to cripple faith as hearing that death report. Fear of family and kinfolks. Hallelujah, Jairus is going to our house with Jesus. And Jesus is going home with me. Can you imagine that? Woo-hoo-hoo! He coming home with me. Baby's going to live. Baby's going to live. And he walks in the door, and they're having a tumult. That just simply means that they were throwing a grief fit. He came in. Jesus just walked in there. I mean, a man that smiles at funerals is just trouble. And people don't want that.
That's right.
And he walks in there and said, he said, she's not dead. She's asleep. Now, all of a sudden, they're laughing at him, scorning him, putting him down. Now, it's obvious. It's not going to do to leave them in there. We got to get rid of them. Jesus didn't even allow 9 of his own staff in there. They had to stay outside. And the Bible said Jesus ran them all out. Mom-in-laws, grandmothers, granddaddies, uncles and aunts and everybody else. He ran them out the house. Well, can you imagine what's flashing through Jairus' mind here? He's got faith daughters going to be raised up. But mom-in-law has been run out of the house. Grandmother has been chased out the door. It said he would not allow anyone in there except the parents. And Peter, James, and John. Mimi and Pawpaw's out there on the front porch. Madder and Hooter Bill's goat. Now, I'm telling you, we find out right now where this man got any faith or not. If he turned and looked at Sister Jairus one time, it was all over. If he turned and one time, he's contaminated the atmosphere. But he didn't do it.
Praise God.
He just stayed with his faith. And feared not, just like Joshua, just like Caleb, just like Joseph, just like the others that he knew from the book. And the daughter was raised up. And it was not just the anointing of Jesus that did it. His uncontaminated faith ran the household and gave room for the Son of Love to do what he was sent to do. He allowed him to be himself any way he wanted to. If he wants to run mom and them out, run. If I have to go, I'm going to go. That's the way love thinks. Love doesn't get offended. Amen. Love says, that girl's going to live if I have to leave here. I don't care who gets run out of here. Jesus is my man. I know who he is. I know that anointing. I just got through seeing it right down the block there. I know. He said the same thing to me that he said to that woman. He used that same word. He used the big word. He used the giant word, the big Hebrew bombshell, shalom. Whoa. Life instead of death. Faith instead of fear. Thank you.
The world around you says you've got to look out for yourself and compete to survive. But God's plan for you is the opposite. He created you to abide in the power of His love. Learn how God's peace and prosperity flow freely in your life when you know and believe the love He has for you. In this series, Kenneth Copeland will show you from the Word of God how love makes a way. No matter what challenges and obstacles arise, it positions you to succeed. Walking in love is tied to receiving the blessing of the Lord. Train your mind to stay in alignment with Him and the understanding that He loves you without limits. When you are born again, you were recreated in His image. You have the same spiritual DNA as Jesus, and that means you can now walk in love with God and people, just like Him. Enter into His rest and let the blessing work in your life. Know and believe God's love for you. Know and Believe the Love by Kenneth Copeland will answer your questions and convince you beyond any doubt that the love God has for you is without limits. Receive your copy free on MP3 or DVD at kcm.org.uk/TV special or call 01-225-787-310. Postage charges may apply. Contact your regional office today.
I want to remind you of what Jesus said to Jairus. Fear not, believe only, and your daughter will be made whole. Jesus' words to Jairus are still true for us today. Fear not, believe only, and you'll receive God's promises into your life. God's love for you is so great, and He's given you promises in His Word so you can receive His goodness every single day. Now, to help build your faith to receive God's promises in your life, the Copelands have a wonderful gift for you. It's called Know and Believe the Love by Kenneth Copeland. When you know that God loves you, it's easy to reach out in faith and receive His blessing. Discover the scriptures that prove God's love for you and let them develop your trust in God's goodness. Grow your faith by hearing God's word of love to you and receive every good thing your Heavenly Father wants you to enjoy. To request your free copy of Know and Believe the Love, go to kcm.org. Thank you so much for joining us. We'll see you again tomorrow. Until next time, this is Brother Larry reminding you, God loves you, we love you, and Jesus is Lord.
Kenneth and Gloria Copeland want to thank you for joining us on the Believer's Voice of Victory broadcast. To learn more about Kenneth Copeland Ministries and how we can help you grow in faith, check out our website for free content and resources available to you on kcm.org.uk.